G'day everybody, this is part 2 in my series on making custom balloons for Dialog Manager for Godot 4. If you haven't seen part 1, then you should probably check that out first and then come back here, because I'm going to be starting with the project that I ended with in that one. So let's get started. The first thing I want to do is make a correction to part 1. So this line here where we have file access.fileExist should really be resourceLoader.exist. So the reason for that is file access checks the literal file. So these PNGs that it's actually checking for, they don't exist in the exported build. Only the import does, which is what the resource loader checks for. And another thing we want to change is down here, this null should now be an empty string. This time property is now strongly typed to be a string. Previously it was loose typed, but in the new version of Dialog Manager, it's now strongly typed. Speaking of a new version of Dialog Manager, the new version's available here. Remember, you can always read the release notes in case there's any important information that you need for the new version. Like in this one, it mentions the change in the null to a string. So let's download that update and reload the project. Okay, now that we have version 2.29.2, there's a couple of new things that we can leverage to make stuff a little bit cleaner. So in runtime settings, you can now specify your custom balloon directly. So this pairs with a new method, which I'll show you in a second. But to start with, we'll just set our balloon. So previously we set the custom test scene, but you can still do that if you want to have some, I don't know, complicated test scene. But for this, we don't need it. We'll just reset it back to the default one. And then we can get rid of our test scene here. And instead, we'll just make a main scene. And then in our project settings, we'll make that the main scene. So now when we run this, it'll do nothing, but it'll just be our blank scene. Cool. Now we can just add a script here where all it's going to do is show our dialog. So we have this new method, show dialog balloon. So it will show the dialog balloon that we configured in settings just before, and it takes the same two main arguments that we would normally send to the example balloon, which is a dialog resource and a title to start from. So now when we run it, we should get an error actually. We did. Key start not found. So I've seen a few people ask what this means, and the simple answer is there is no title with start in our main dialog. This is the title here. So if we change that to start, save that. Now when we run our main scene again, we should be fine. And it just plays from the start. So previously you would have to set up your own custom code for adding your custom balloon to the scene. So this just makes it a little bit simpler if you don't want to do that. You can still have complicated or custom stuff to add your balloon to the scene if you're doing something out of the ordinary, but in general this should be suffice for most stuff. If you want to see what that actually does, you can jump into it. All it does is instantiate the balloon, add it to the scene. Nothing fancy. Oh, and starts the balloon. That's probably all you need to know about that. So next up, let's add some talking noises to our balloon. So to make a sound when characters talk, we first need a sound. So I have this sound file here that I just took out of the Dialog Manager examples folder. It sounds like this. So it generally makes a blip with each letter that's typed out here. So to set that up, we grab the dialog label. It has a spoke signal, so we connect to that. And what gets given in here is the actual letter spoke, the index in the string that that letter is, and the current typing speed. So we probably don't need the letter index or the speed. Initially, we'll just play that sound. So we need a reference to the sound first, actually. So in our scene, we should add a audio stream player. We'll just call it talk sound. And we can reference it up here. And we want to hook up that sound. Then back down here, we can just go talk sound.play. And let's see what that does. Okay, let's add some pauses for in between words. Okay, so if a letter isn't a space or a full stop, then we'll play the sound. Let's try that. Okay, that still sounds a bit flat. Let's add some pitch variation. Okay, so for each letter spoken, it will pitch up or pitch down by just a little bit. Okay, that sounds a bit better. Okay, we can slow it down a little bit. So in our dialogue label, its by default is 0.02 of a second per letter spoken. So if we double that to 0.4, that'll slow everything down by a little bit. Okay, that sounded pretty good. And remember that the pitch and the seconds per step and all this stuff, it's all variable per character. So you can have some characters by default speak fast, some speak slow. You can change the sound that's played per character. You can set a default pitch or pitch range per character as well. It's totally up to you how far you want to take this for your game. The next thing we'll add to our dialogue balloon is a progress indicator to show when you can press next to get to the next line. I've added this SVG file here, which will be the graphic we'll use for it. So let's add a texture rect to the balloon. And we'll just anchor it to the bottom right. And we'll call it indicator. And drag our texture on. Put it in a better spot. Okay, that's probably good. Now let's hook it up. So we can add a reference to it. Now what we can do here is we can leverage the waiting for input check, because the indicator will only be visible when we're waiting for input. Okay, so now when we're waiting for input, it'll be visible. If not, it won't be visible. Okay, we want it invisible to start with, so in our ready function, we'll just hide it. Okay, let's give that a whirl. There we go. So you notice here when we have input from responses, it automatically won't show because we're not waiting for input on the balloon itself. Okay, we can make this a bit better. We'll make it go up and down with a little animation. So we could make this a custom node, but for now I'm just going to keep it simple. Just add an animation player here directly. Make it the default, make it loop, and we'll just bob it up and down. Use Bezier curves so that it's a bit smoother. We don't need a reset track. And just key the start and end the same. And then we'll move it up just a little bit. Oops. Key it again. Yeah, we probably don't need X at all, actually. Let's see how that looks. There you go. And it's that simple. In just a few minutes, we've added noises for when it types out and a progress indicator. If you have any other questions or ideas for things you want to add to your custom balloons, then drop a comment below or join my Discord. And just like part one, the project files for this custom balloon are up on my Patreon. I'd like to give a shout out to my Cockatoo supporters, Mario J. Roberti, Mark Lucia, Skia, and Vanillid, and my Owl supporter, Linus Minus. That's all from me for now. I'll see you again soon. Bye.